Inkscape 1.2 beta is out, yay! While it has lots of accessibility improvements I'm going to tell you about in this video, the new multi-page support breaks our usual PDF export workflow. Since now I have to show you the new ways to create projectable files, it makes sense to also talk about the new cool features. As usual, I will only touch those useful for sewing. Layers and objects dialogs are now one, and it's now safe to leave them open and actually use. I especially like that I can press Alt and hover over the list to highlight the object. Sometimes I know which path I need but can't select it by clicking, or not quite sure where it's hidden. Not anymore. On canvas alignment snapping is probably useful to illustrators, but I only show the way to switch it off. I find it doesn't help with pattern editing, and actually gets in the way all the time. It's here, in the new snapping toolbar, I actually do not like. Because now it's nailed to the upper right corner and can't be put at the top. And it's a long way across my big screen. Otherwise, it's way easier to use with the text labels. Stroke style now has customizable markers, and those are so useful for notches. There is one I especially like, little scissors, and now you can scale it, rotate it, change direction and whatnot. Now I do all my notches as short path lines with big scissors markers. We can now precisely scale objects in one direction. I think this will be useful when I finally get around to the size grading tutorial. It seems that deep Ungroup extension is finally working for me too. Still slow, but ungroups everything in one step. But it doesn't remove clipping automatically. So if the areas of the pattern have disappeared, just select all and go Object, Clip, Release Clip. I really like the new accessibility options. Tools and toolbar icons can be enlarged separately and smoothly without restart. You can now hide tools from the toolbar. That is useful for laptop screens. And when have you used diagram or zoom tool last? Probably never. The text can be made bigger, interface contrast can be adjusted. The default theme is dark. Apparently, we live in dark ages, and default dark themes are everywhere. I can stand them myself, a definitely bad idea for video tutorials, so I have changed mine and used the most colorful icons I can choose. I significantly enlarged icons and handles, and might enlarge the text for video recordings as well. Now we came to saving and exporting. If you open a multi-page pattern like this one by apostrophe, you can now import all pages at once instead of just one, yay again! Still cannot choose a page range, but that is in the works. But you cannot just save the pattern to PDF like we used to do. Because pages are still there with their specific sizes, and we simply want our endless pattern with big empty buffer, right? Even worse, if we import a few different files and then delete the patterns, extra pages will remain. There are two options. The one I like more is using Export instead of Save As. Single image, document, will ignore the pages and just export everything as one page. Uncheck Hide Export Settings to still see the same PDF export dialog. Choose PDF from the format dropdown below. It's PNG by default. There you can convert to text or not, and then bleed that would work as an empty buffer. The other way uses the new pages functionality. I will make page borders visible for this step. At the bottom of the toolbar there is a new pages tool. It can create and, more important to us, delete pages and also resize them. Delete all but one, you cannot delete the last one, and resize it to form big empty buffer around the pattern pieces. This way, saving as PDF will create one page document with big empty buffer, just like before. This method assumes that you can see the pages, keeping the border visible or setting a color for pages. And I personally prefer to work with empty white field. But that is up to you. Pages can be useful to separate pieces for different sizes of fabrics in one file, so everything is neatly organized but still kept together. Another cool feature is my shiny new Discord server, come to talk about Inkscape for sewing. I will be waiting for your comments and suggestions. I try to be nice, and I always answer,